Deep in a refrigerated vault, on the snowy hillside of a remote island in the Arctic Circle, a library of seeds may be humanity's only hope for botanical salvation. Hi everyone, Crystal here for DNews with some good news about the apocalypse. It's probably already here, but the Earth's plants may survive, and through them, humans could too. If we draw an analogy between the apocalypse and a rapid mass extinction of the number and variety of living things on Earth, we may just be in the middle of one. Mass extinctions, like the one that killed the dinosaurs, are characterized by a narrowing of biodiversity due to environmental change. And some scientists say that's happening right now. Estimates place the current rate of extinction of plants and animals at anywhere from 100 to 1,000 times faster than our recent geological past. And this rate appears poised to increase as our globe continues to warm, human populations continue to expand, and geographical regions continue to be devastated by wars and natural disaster. Humans have been concerned about protecting the Earth's biodiversity since biblical times. I mean, why else would we have a story about animals lining up two by two to be preserved on a giant ark? Biodiversity refers to the number and variety of living species within an ecosystem. And this variety, specifically among plants, is crucial for human survival, since plants are the source of our nutrients and energy, as well as providing shelter and the starting point for many medicines. Seed banks, like the Svalbard Global Seed Vault, are one way to preserve the biodiversity of commercially significant crops and of wild native plants. These libraries of seeds can be used to reintroduce species into existing habitats or to strengthen genetically depleted populations. But maintaining a one-stop shop of viable seeds can be costly and challenging. Recognizing the need for a more secure global effort, an organization called the Crop Trust, with support from many well-known private foundations, has stepped in. Their most dramatic program maintains an enormous warehouse with the capacity to house a cache of 4.5 million varieties of seeds. Located on a Norwegian island north of the Arctic Circle, this vault is envisioned as a failsafe, a backup to smaller, more local seed banks. And in fact, that's exactly how it's being used. The first and only seed withdrawal was made by Syria, who used seeds they had previously deposited to reconstruct a seed bank recently destroyed by civil war. Currently, more than 864,000 species of plant life from over 100 countries are being preserved within the cold, dry interior of this vault, and its contents are estimated to approach half of the known microflora, like trees and grains, on the planet. As this is a global project with diplomatic implications, concerns over seed ownership have naturally arisen. And for now, the vault acts as a high-tech storage facility, filtering out possible genetic duplications in deposits, but also ensuring that only the original depositor will have access to their contribution. This restriction is to protect the library of heirloom seeds from exploitation and for-profit manipulation by biotech companies or agribusiness. Now, not everyone agrees that locking up the seeds to every known plant on Earth is the way to go. Some critics say libraries like these are just historical records, offering simply a snapshot in evolutionary time, and that the plants preserved by this method would have a low chance of survival after reintroduction. Plants resulting from the preserved seeds wouldn't have had a chance to evolve with the demands of their environment, and they may lack resistance to modern pests and disease. Opponents of the seed bank approach often focus on commercial crops and advocate for preservation of seed diversity in the fields. This in situ preservation requires the long-term cooperation of farming communities to cultivate a variety of the same crops over generations. But, for example, with emphasis on profit, it seems unlikely that farmers would be able or willing to keep growing every known variety of corn if they were only making big money on one. So debate continues as to which path is best. Large libraries of genetic diversity like the Svalbard Global Seed Vault inspire the imagination. Will astronauts of the future be eating ancient forms of terrestrial plants that just happen to survive the demands of space? The existence of homegrown lettuce on the International Space Station says maybe. Evolution needs a starting point, and whether it is a seed bank or a library of biodiversity with galactic significance, when it comes to life, more is better. And may the best seed win. Want to know more about mass extinction? Lacey has your answers.
Currently, we're losing about 27,000 species every year just because of the tropical rainforest being reduced. Animals are dying off in large numbers. For instance, the invertebrates like butterflies, beetles, and spiders have declined 45% in 35 years.
We want to know what you think. Are seed banks the answer? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching.